This is Bulgarian stone forest, Pobiti Kamani. This isn't just a 50-million-year-old time capsule, it's a locale veiled in mystery. Once submerged beneath an ancient sea, it's now a desert in Europe. Is it nature's masterpiece or a forgotten civilization's creation? Join me as we explore theories, unearth ancient tales of titans and gods, discover evidence of the first prehistoric civilization in Europe, encounter the world's oldest gold treasure and jewelry, and unravel the enigma of this extraordinary place. When the first Western traveler laid eyes on Pobiti Kamani near Varna, the site was so surreal that Viktor Tepliakov, a special missions officer in the Russian army during the Russo-Turkish War of 1828-1829, had to rein in his horse. The massive stone pillars emerging from the sandy, shrub-covered wilderness left him stunned. He wanted to dismount and look over the strange stone pillars. But Colonel Alexander von Luders, who was leading the march, had no time to waste. Tepliakov managed to convince him to spare a few minutes and allow him to dig around the foundations of one of the columns, only when they realized that the stone pillars around them stretched for miles. Tepliakov did not succeed in unearthing the base of the column. It was stuck too deep in the ground.
When you emerge from the depths of the surrounding forest, you are faced with an expanse of land with a pile of gigantic columns sticking up in front of you. Their location does not follow any order or common architectural pattern. The thousands of splendid columns will strike you with their most weird forms. In some places, they reason the form of perfect cylinders, while in others, they look like towers or broken pyramids or truncated cones. Some are wide at their base and seem as if encircled with broad cornices. There are hillocks so thick with pillars that they remind me of the ruins of an ancient gallery. Some of them are hollow, and their core is filled with a gray, sandy mass.
He wrote to his friend, Retkol Grigory Rimsky-Korsakov. This description marks the first documentation of the natural wonder of Pobiti Kamani. The area, spanning more than 70 sq km, has become a popular tourist destination near Varna, known also as Dikilitash, derived from Turkish meaning stones beaten into the ground. Along the old road to Sofia, over 300 stone pillars, some exceeding 9 meters in height, dot the landscape. Tepliakov held a fascinating belief that Pobiti Kamani might be the remnants of an unknown prehistoric civilization, possibly linked to the creators of the colossal structures at Tiryns and Mycenae in Greece. Some Bulgarian scientists and researchers present a compelling perspective, backed by evidence of human activity dating back to the Mesolithic era, 9600 BCE. They propose that the site, Pobiti Kamani, was intentionally arranged by the ancient local population to function as a solar calendar. During the solar equinoxes and solstices on March 20th, June 20th, September 22, and December 21st, the struck stones align with the sun in its four cardinal locations. Openings in the stones, often shaped like triangular pyramids and some exceeding a meter in length, serve as precise monitors for the sun's positions during these cardinal solar moments, either at sunrise or sunset. Moreover, the stones inclined at 82 degrees display an effective resistance to water erosion. Curiously, in the immediate vicinity lies a village named Slunchevo, meaning sunny, with one group of stones located on its outskirts. Some researchers have discovered that certain stones align remarkably accurately with the positions of stars above them. One group even resembles a depiction of the starry sky above Earth, often forming elliptical constellations. Moreover, specific mathematical notches on some stones, repeated in a peculiar manner, suggest a potential significance related to the marked star. Where are these maps pointing?
I think they want us to come and find them.
Let's dig in the local tales and maybe we can find some clues. Legends surround Pobiti Kamani, and one stands out, a tale of a young man granted immortality by God. But sharing God's name meant losing this gift. This enchanting story unfolds in a distant time when the place was a serene seashore.
One fateful day on the beach, the young man, amidst the sea's whispers and the golden sands, found his heart captivated by the beauty of a girl from the nearest village. He asked in the village and revealed that the Titan King desired her as a wife. Driven by love, the young man embarked on a quest to free the girl from this fate. His journey led him to the Titan King and his colossal giants, who resided in the vicinity. He approached the king and asked him to release the girl, and he agreed, but in return he wanted to know God's name. The young man, deeply in love, asked for time to think. Knowing he'd lose his immortality, he agreed the next morning. At dawn, a solemn procession unfolded as the young man aligned the titans and wrote the god's name on the sandy canvas with their bodies. Touched by the young man's love and sacrifice, God turned the titans to stone. To this day, these petrified guardians stand vigil in the desert, preserving the secret of God's name. Where the young man once stood, sacrificing his immortality for love, now stands a stone with a heart-shaped hole. In the summer, when the sun is high, it casts a heart-shaped shadow on the sands.
As the legend continues, the narrative takes an unexpected turn. After facing challenges, the young man hugged the girl, and as they kissed, healing water miraculously appeared under their feet. Now, a stream flows 500 meters from the stones, known as Bulgaria's most healing water source, offering solace and remedy to those afflicted with kidney problems. The mystery endures, with whispers among the locals suggesting that decoding the stone pillars' positions may unlock the true name of God. This legend raises intriguing questions. Could the name of God, encoded in the positions of the petrified titans, serve as a star map, hinting at the celestial origin of our Creator, our God? When humans first appeared in these lands, Pobiti Kamani already stood, fully formed, challenging the imagination. Tepliakov's belief that the rocks resembled columns of ancient temples held some truth. Prehistoric Bulgarians even created a shrine near one group of stone pillars. Pobiti Kamani stands as the sole location in Bulgaria where evidence of human life dating back to the Mesolithic era, 9600 BCE, 5800 BCE, has been unearthed. Remarkably, this site is near Varna Necropolis, an internationally renowned burial site considered a cornerstone in world prehistory. At this necropolis, the oldest gold treasure and jewelry ever discovered, dating from 4600 BC to 4200 BC, were found. The sheer weight and quantity of gold artifacts in the Varna cemetery far surpass those unearthed in all other sites from the same millennium, 5000-4000 BC, worldwide, including Mesopotamia and Egypt. This transforms the necropolis into evidence of the emergence of the first prehistoric civilization in Europe, and possibly the entire world. Even today, the 3,000 exquisite artifacts, with a combined weight exceeding 6 kilos, crafted around 6,500 years ago, stand unparalleled on the planet. Half a century after the discovery of the necropolis, which caused a global sensation, scientists continue to seek connections among the people buried there. Everything indicates that the site held sacred significance for ancient communities. Some scholars speculate that Varna Necropolis housed leaders of great importance within a vast intertribal alliances territory. This raises numerous questions, one of which is whether this place was sacred for multiple tribes and nations. It's possible that the necropolis was intentionally established near Pobiti Kamani, signifying its exceptional importance in the distant past. In subsequent scholarly publications, the civilization in these areas is distinguished as an independent phenomenon, and terms such as pre-civilization and pre-state organization emerge in interpretations related to it. In the upcoming videos, we will specifically focus on the world's oldest processed gold and attempt to unveil more secrets of the ancient people who inhabited these lands. The man who made the first scientific evaluation of Dikilitash thinks that it was an act of nature. Like Tepliakov, he was a foreigner, an army officer, and visiting the area because of a war. He was not Russian and was past the age of youthful euphoria. Thomas Spratt, a 43-year-old captain in the British Royal Navy, saw Pobiti Kamani in 1854 during the Crimean War.
On the whole, they were believed to be artificially created. Perhaps the remains of a huge temple of some earlier people, for example. A perfunctory glance might certainly suggest that they were shaped for some such purpose by man. but a more careful eye would notice their irregular position, shape, and height, which shows clearly that they were not made artificially. Because there are several that are partially formed in the rocks in the area, the similarity of this stone mass to a cromlech or a druidic altar naturally leads to the idea that they have some connection with the early beliefs of the East. They might have been used in this way and adapted to the religious ideas and services of earlier people, but they are certainly not a construction or creation of man. They are, in my opinion, natural creations,
wrote Spratt in the Quarterly Journal of the Geological Society, London, in 1857. There, he also published the first engraving of the rock phenomenon. Geologists still debate the origin of Pobiti Kamani's sandstone pillars. Some suggest they are remnants of primeval organisms like coral reefs or petrified trees. The prevailing theory, however, argues against an organic origin. Around 50 million years ago, northeastern Bulgaria was the bottom of a lake, with natural gas deposits rising to the surface. Bubbles, oxidizing methane and water, led to the gradual formation of calcium carbonate pillars. Over millennia, these pillars petrified. As the sea dried up, the columns emerged, enduring the elements of wind, rain, cold, and heat. Most columns are inclined at an 82-degree angle. A decade ago, Belgian scientist Eva de Boever proposed that recent research suggests formation in relatively shallow sea depths around openings enriched with methane fluids. Similar columns, discovered underwater near Denmark's shores, revealed thriving anaerobic bacteria feeding on methane, secreting a cement-forming substance around bubbling vents. It takes approximately 350 years to form 1 centimeter. A recent study found remnants of the same bacterial species amid Pobiti Kamani's columns. Nestled close to the expansive Pobiti Kamani, the secret treasure known as the Heavenly Doors unveils itself just a stone's throw away from the more frequented sites. While adjacent to, but distinct from Pobiti Kamani, this hidden enclave enchants the rare visitor with its mystical charm. It resembles an ancient underwater castle, adorned with numerous pillars, creating a scene reminiscent of Neptune's mythical realm.
Heavenly doors evoke the imagery of Neptune's castle, with majestic pillars forming an enchanting backdrop. One can almost imagine mermaids dancing gracefully between the planted stones, while Neptune himself sits regally on his throne, overseeing the mesmerizing spectacle.
Despite its proximity to the well-trodden paths of Pobiti Kamani, the heavenly doors remain elusive, requiring a determined explorer to navigate through rugged terrain. However, the beauty held within these planted stones is at odds with the unfortunate reality of neglect. Unlike its renowned counterpart, the heavenly doors suffer from a lack of attention and care from the state. There are no informative signs or guided trails to provide context to those who chance upon this hidden sanctuary. The absence of such amenities leaves visitors without the historical and geological background that could enhance their experience. Adding to the sense of abandonment is the unwelcome presence of a nearby dump, starkly contrasting with the natural wonder of the heavenly doors. This unfortunate pairing serves as a stark reminder of the delicate balance between nature's marvels and human disregard. The lack of proper oversight not only robs the heavenly doors of the recognition they deserve, but also puts their structural integrity at risk. The relentless march of time, coupled with the impact of weather and human activities, contributes to the slow erosion of this ancient marvel. In the face of neglect, the heavenly doors embody a paradox, awe-inspiring natural beauty set against a backdrop of human indifference. These planted stones not only carry the history of an ancient underwater-like castle, but also a silent plea for acknowledgement and safeguarding from the perils of neglect. The territory that encompasses present-day Bulgaria conceals incredible places, unveiling fragments of the mysterious past of ancient civilizations that preceded our modern society. The lands where the stone desert now stands were once at the bottom of the ancient Liutet Sea millions of years ago. Today, this location hosts one of the two naturally formed deserts in Europe. The other is Tabernas in Spain. While smaller in size and certainly not comparable to Spain's Tabernas Desert, here, amidst its fine sands, countless unique rock formations are scattered, a phenomenon unparalleled worldwide, known as the planted stones. Pobiti Kamani, despite its desert-like appearance, harbors a fascinating array of flora. Within this unique desert landscape, one can discover rare and intriguing plant species, adding to the allure of the site. The territory of Pobiti Kamani boasts the presence of distinctive flora, including but not limited to cactus, desert rose, acacia, phlox, and more. One botanical highlight is the exclusive occurrence of the Arenaria rigida plant, making Pobiti Kamani the sole locality for this particular species in Bulgaria. Amidst the ancient stone pillars and sandy expanses, these resilient and rare plants contribute to the ecological diversity of the region, creating a remarkable botanical tapestry within the confines of this intriguing Bulgarian desert. Numerous archaeological studies and investigations are needed to piece together the full puzzle. As we wrap up our exploration, let this journey through Pobiti Kamani inspire curiosity and appreciation for the mysteries that lie beneath the surface of this ancient land. If you've enjoyed this adventure, consider subscribing for more captivating discoveries. Stay tuned for upcoming videos where we'll delve into the world's oldest processed gold and unravel more secrets of the ancient people who inhabited these lands. Thank you for joining me on this fascinating adventure, and until next time, keep exploring the wonders of our world.